Today, I'm talking about my struggle with the word unisex and asking for your help to find a new word. Hello and welcome. If you haven't subscribed, do it right now while you're thinking about it. I would love to see you again. Today I'm talking about my struggle with the word unisex. And I'm a designer. Most of what I design is jewelry. And I design jewelry for anybody who feels a connection with it, male or female. So a lot of people say that's unisex jewelry. And my response is, no, it's just jewelry. I just design jewelry. If you like it, you can wear it. But the further I go along in this process, more and more people want to pin me into men's, women's, or sometimes unisex. They'll just call me a unisex designer. I've always sort of had a problem with the word unisex or even men's and women's, but it really hit home for me when I started designing jewelry. I design jewelry to be worn by anyone who feels a connection with it, male or female. I don't think of it as men's jewelry. I don't think of it as women's jewelry. I don't think of it as unisex jewelry. I just think of it as jewelry. And if you like it, you can wear it. But everybody seems to want to classify not only all jewelry, but my jewelry too. You know, I was at a trade show recently, and this happens quite a bit, where I had my jewelry out and people come by to look at the jewelry, and these are mostly jewelry store owners in this case, and they're coming by to look at the jewelry and decide whether they should put it in their cases. And in this case, it was my Prelude bracelet. So a woman comes up and she looked at my cases and she said, well, I can see where, you know, most of this stuff could be worn by men or women, but this bracelet, this is definitely a woman's bracelet, and she put it on. So then after she's through doing her shopping, a man comes by, looks at the same Prelude bracelet and says, oh yeah, I can see where all of this stuff could be for men or women, but this bracelet, this is definitely a man's bracelet. So the real truth of it is that both of these people loved the bracelet, felt a connection with it, felt that it was for them, but then had to justify in their mind that they were allowed to have it, that it was definitely for them because this one was for their gender. I struggle with even the concept of that. I just don't understand it. And yet I live in this world where people want to classify my jewelry. And we don't do this for everything. Nobody says, may I offer you a women's glass of orange juice or a gender neutral glass of orange juice? Or, you know, we don't have a unisex driveway, although men or women can drive on it. My car is not considered men's or women's. You know, we deal with a lot of things that are well designed that we don't feel compelled to say are just for men or women. But the minute, it seems to me, it's the minute that it's on our body. When it gets to be on our body, that's when we start classifying men's, women's, and now unisex. There have been some changes in my lifetime, I will tell you, because when I was younger, men had very short hair, went to the barber, women went to a hairdresser. That whole thing has been broken now. Women are able to wear shorter hair, men are able to wear longer hair, and they even put it in ponytails and buns and use barrettes and all kinds of things. And now that barber or hairdresser is generally called a stylist. And when you say the word stylist, you don't think man or woman, it could be either one, and the person who goes to it could be either one. So we're making progress. Another area that I think we're making progress is in the area of tattoos. When I was young, tattoos were a very masculine thing. First of all, not many people had them, but if they did, they were men. Very few women had a tattoo, and it was not okay in the eyes of a lot of people if they did. So we've broken that. But somehow in clothing or adornment from sort of the neck down, we're still having trouble. I mean, even earrings. When I was younger, men were just starting to wear earrings more and more, and that has become more accepted. And I don't think there's too much of a distinction between maybe a man's hoop or a man's stud and a woman's hoop or a woman's stud. I would just like to see us get all the way there with jewelry and even with clothing. And this is not to say that these things aren't masculine or feminine. And I've done a whole video on masculine and feminine in design. That doesn't mean men's and women's. But here I am with this struggle because everybody wants to call it unisex. And I'll tell you some of my problems with the word unisex. First of all, uni means one, and then there's sex. So it sounds like you're saying one sex, which isn't exactly accurate. And then It can also sound sort of asexual. And I happen to think my jewelry is pretty sexy. And then it can also sound androgynous. And that's another thing. Androgynous is a word that makes sense to me, but not all unisex is androgynous. So a lot of times when people hear the word unisex, or they talk about my jewelry as unisex, or they do some unisex expo, or they talk about unisex design, they think of it as progress. And I guess in a way it's some progress, but it's not, we're not all the way there. It's one of the steps, because the problem is this unisex concept, or at least the connotation of the word, can be stripping down good design and sort of neutering it, bringing it to the center, and taking the pizzazz out of it. And I don't think that that needs to happen ever. I think you can have pieces that make a big statement, big bold design, or a quiet, subtle, awesome design that are for anybody. And I like the expansiveness of for everybody, as opposed to unisex, which is sounding more kind of reserved and constrained and defined. And so for a long time, I just told people, just don't say anything, just put it there and it's for anybody. And then what I found was, you know, people would assume it was either for women or for men. So the struggle is real. I don't know what to do. And I don't care for the word unisex. I really try not to use it in association with my jewelry. If somebody does use that word, it's fine, it's no offense. I just don't feel like it fits me. And I don't feel like it fits a lot of people who are trying to expand our options and not limit them. So I could use your help. What do you think about the word unisex? What do you think about the term gender neutral? Do you have an idea for some other term? Should we create another term? Or do we just not need a term and just need to get over it and just say it is what it is? It's jewelry, it's a dress, it's a pair of boots. If they fit you, if you want to wear it, if you feel a connection with it, it's yours. Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. I would love to see you again. Bye for now. Thank you.